These little crocuses won't last long, but they're a sure sign of spring. Hello, everyone. Well, I think spring has finally sprung here in Michigan, and I've got a long weekend. I'm in between projects, so I thought I'd make another of my two-faced pumpkins. I made him a couple years ago, and I wished I had did a how-to on him because he was so easy to make. I did the plastic corpsing method, starting with chicken wire and tie wire, and I wove the tie wire through the chicken wire and left plenty of it hanging out the bottom for attaching. We put him on the corner of our hedges the last couple of seasons, and he stayed nice and secure and stood the test of time with all the wind and the rain. So unlike him, I plan on airbrushing my new pumpkin. I used a paintbrush with him, which was a nightmare with all these crevices, so I'm thinking airbrushing is definitely the way to go. So I'm anxious to get started. Let me grab my chicken wire and wire cutters, and I'll be right back. Okay, this is basically all I need to get started. Here's my tie wire, my chicken wire, a wire cutter, and a needle nose pliers. Okay, well, it's the next day, and I didn't do a very good job of my videotaping yesterday, so I'm giving it another go so you can see how I did this here. I cut 40 inches of the chicken wire, I split it up the middle, and now I'm going to take these two segments and basically sew them together. You see how they are curled opposite of each other? I'm going to put the curls back to back. I'm going to twist this wire over here just to keep it in place. Pat gave me that tip. And he's helping me with my videotaping today, so can do a little better job. All right, so now I'm just going to take this tie wire, which I've cut extra long, so I can have plenty of excess hanging out on either end, because that's what I'm going to be using to fasten it down in the end. But anyway, I'm just going to sew like a needle and thread with this tie wire through the chicken wire. I'm going to use my fingers at first, and I can grab my long nose pliers and work my way through. Okay, so I will get this woven through and I'll be back when I'm done. Okay, I've got my tie wire all woven through here, basically. Just gonna take it, and as a rule of thumb, all of your raw edges as you're connecting these are gonna be to the inside of the pumpkin so that you don't have anything poking through when you do your plastic corpsing. I cut out 10 sections for my pumpkin and just went along and connected them in this manner, keeping in mind the raw edges to the inside. And then you'll complete the circle. And the only thing left is adding the stem, and now we're to the plastic corpsing process. So that's that. All right, I basically have all my segments sewn together, and now I'm gonna take one end and join it to the next, and then shape it into a pumpkin. Okay, still the same day. It's just got a little later in the day and cooler. I'm almost done with my chicken wire work, which is actually the worst part of the whole project. Tomorrow I plan to do the corpsing. I'm just attaching the stem here, and I've got this tie wire running right up from the pumpkin, woven right through the stem. So everything is going to be nice and tight and secure, won't be coming apart. I'm gonna just take my time now and twist and turn and make sure everything is nice and tight before I start the plastic corpsing tomorrow. So I've got my basic pumpkin shape here. If you can see, I'm all ready for my plastic corpsing. Okay, I'm ready to start my plastic corpsing. I've got all of my attachments for when he's all finished and for wherever we put him. This is what we're going to anchor him down with. So I got the plastic laid out, I cut a hole here. I'm gonna fish all this wire through here, and then I can bring the plastic up and start with the heat gun. I got that roll of black plastic because that's what I want for my base coat anyway. So I'm ready to get started, and I'll be back when I'm doing the heat gun process. Now I'm here doing the corpsing process. It's a little bit time consuming. The black plastic is maybe a little bit thicker than what I'm used to working with, but it just means the heat gun's gotta hang on a little longer. But it's just gonna take some time and a little finesse, and I think he'll be taking shape the next time you see him. Okay, I'm pretty much done with my plastic corpsing. Took the afternoon, ready to put my two faces on. I tidied up the bottom here so that everything is all the wires that I'm going to be connecting with come October are all there and ready and nice and sturdy. So just got to figure out a couple faces, and then we'll do the details, and then airbrushing will be after that. Okay, this is the way I'm doing the face detail. I just cut my black plastic into thin strips, then I'm just building it up as I go. I just keep going around till I've got it defined enough to where I think I can have them, you know, the facial features stand out enough, so. Okay, end of day two. I've got both of my faces finished, and tomorrow I plan to airbrush. Okay everyone, it is Sunday and I'm about to airbrush for the first time. So hey, I've been having so much fun with my airbrush, I almost forgot to show you my progress. I've just got some greens to add to the stem and a few highlights, and he's been all sealed up with the Minwax polyurethane satin spray. He took 4 days from start to finish. This is a great project for anybody who doesn't like the paper mache, because he was super clean, no mess. And you can make him any size or shape that you like. It was also a great first airbrushing project for me. I had a blast painting him up. I'll definitely be doing more of that in the future. So I've got one more project I want to show you that I've finished up since the last time I talked to you. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope I inspired, and I'll talk to you soon.